Ideally, we have information about a product's price elasticity available when we try to construct its demand curve, but we don't always have that information available to us for a variety of reasons, including research cost and lack of reliable data. If you want to construct a demand curve for a product that you don't have accurate elasticity data for, you can use an ingenious method devised by HBS's own Robert Doland. You need to come up with 3 points on the product's demand curve: the lowest price you'd consider charging for the product, and how many units you think you can sell at that price, the highest price you'd consider charging for the product, and how many units you think you can sell at that price, and a price somewhere in the middle, and how many units you think you can sell at that price. Once we have those 3 points, we can use Excel's Add Trendline feature to fit this basic quadratic demand curve. As usual, we're going to let Excel do the hard work of figuring out the best values for the variables A, B, and C for us. Using a quadratic power curve lets the line flex between the points, making it more realistic than a linear demand curve through the high price and low price points. If we can get Excel to give us an equation that fits our 3 known points, it's pretty reasonable to assume that any price point on the resulting demand curve is a decent estimate of demand. And once we have the formula for the demand curve, we can use Excel's solver to find the best price that maximizes our profit margin. So let's try this method out on a real-world example. We're going to step in our time machine and take a short hop back to 2005. We're working for the Wrigley Company, and we've just acquired Altoids from Kraft Foods. We're trying to get a handle on the pricing of our new product, and we can't really wait 6 months for a formal price elasticity study to get done. We could talk to Kraft sales staff and make guesses about demand at high, low, and median prices, but we're smarter than that. We've secretly been conducting a little experiment for the past week at the 3 CVSs around Harvard Square. Lucky for us, those crazy kids around Harvard Square randomly choose a CVS to shop at, and each CVS has roughly the same level of sales. In one CVS, we charged a low price of $1.50 for a package of Altoids. In another, we charged a high price of $3.29 per package. And in the last CVS, we left the price alone at $2.49. CVS has a nice website that makes point-of-sales data available to suppliers, which we use to extract store-level sales data for our 3 CVSs. We see that we sold 93 tens of Altoids at the low price, 72 at the current price, and only 18 at the high price. Let's open up a new Excel workbook and enter our 3 data points. Select the data points by dragging over them with your mouse. Navigate to the Insert tab on the ribbon and select Scatter with Only Markers from the chart group. Right-click one of the data points and choose Add Trendline. Since we want Excel to fit a quadratic curve to our 3 points, select the Polynomial Radio button and set the order box to 2. Check the Display Equation on Chart box and click the Close button. Excel will give us a nice smooth quadratic curve along with its equation. We can extract the values for the variables A, B, and C out of the equation and rewrite them in terms of demand and price. This is our demand formula for any price on the curve. Now, we need to give Excel a guess for what the optimal price might be. We don't have to be close. Excel solver just wants a price to work outwards from. I'm going to use $2.50 per package of Altoids for my guess. Enter our demand formula from the previous step, then accept it. Enter the amount it cost us to manufacture a package of Altoids, 89 cents. The last formula we need before running solver is our standard formula for calculating total profit margin: the price we're charging per unit of product minus the variable cost of producing one unit of product multiplied by the demand at that price. Enter that formula, then accept it. Now we can use solver to find the best price for our product. Navigate to the Data tab on the ribbon and select Solver from the Data Analysis group. We want to maximize our profit by changing the price we charge for our product. We also want to add 2 constraints. We want the price to be between the maximum and minimum we'd consider charging. If we let Solver try prices outside of that range, it may end up on a weird part of the quadratic demand curve, which might falsely indicate that a higher price will lead to higher demand. Click the Add button. Constrain the optimum price to be greater than or equal to our minimum of $1.50 and click OK. Click the Add button again. Now, constrain the optimum price to be less than or equal to our maximum of $3.29, and click OK. Click the Solve button, and the solver will zip off to find our optimized price. When it finishes, solver will leave the best values for price and profit in our worksheet. It looks like we should charge $2.47 for a package of Altoids, which will result in a total profit margin of $115.23 a week for our three CVS stores around Harvard Square. We can now try that pricing on a national basis, and we should see some improved margins.